What's going on, you guys? How's it going? Welcome back to the channel. Today's video is a little bit different. I'm actually going to be going over jersey concepts, but not just any jersey concepts. I'm going over my own jersey concepts. So I made a series over on my Instagram called Modern Classic. I don't know if you guys have seen that. If you guys have been watching my Instagram and you guys have been seeing me go through this series, then you're probably going to really like this video because I'm going to be going through all the jerseys I made and ranking it from my least favorite to my favorite. So it's a little bit different because I know what these designs are because I personally made them. So it is a little bit different ranking jerseys that I've seen and that are personally mine, but I'm going to kind of talk through what I dislike about the jersey that I designed, maybe even what I would have done different. I'm not going to spend too much time on it because it would take forever. Honestly, I sometimes design some jerseys and then I look at them and I'm like, I totally could have improved these, and I kind of know how after the fact, but during it, I make jerseys that I think I like. I also sent these jerseys in to Neil over at Post to Post. I'm assuming that every single person who watches this knows who that is. So it'll be very cool for me to kind of go through and give my opinions on these, but as well as when he uploads his, to kind of see what he thinks about them. Because I wonder if he's going to dislike the same ones that I think I could have done better on. If you guys like this video and you guys want to see more, maybe even see me do some videos designing some jersey concepts. I've tried doing that in the past and honestly, it hasn't done very well. But if that is something you guys like to see me try to reboot on the channel, then make sure to show support on the video by hitting the like button, subscribing, and commenting down below. That helped me out a lot. So like I said, I'm not going to take too much time on each one because honestly, I could probably be here all day just kind of explaining through my thought process. But we'll start off first with the LA Kings. And I'm going to be honest, I don't think there's a lot I would do different here on this jersey. I know I have it last, so that's kind of tough. I think it's just kind of boring. I think I should have went a more fun route with kind of the purple, maybe utilizing some of the yellow. I think I could have taken that silver texture and made it like a purple shiny texture. I think that would have been really fun. The whole goal of this series, for those of you guys who do not know, was to me to take kind of elements from classic jerseys for each team, but then add a modern twist to it. My modern twist here is having the whole entire silver on the sleeve go all the way up. So that silver material that, like, say the Vegas Golden Knights use, having that go all the way up the arm instead of just being on a stripe. I don't think the jersey's bad. Like, I don't think any of the jerseys I designed are bad. I like them. I made them. But I just think it's kind of just boring. Next up, we got the Vegas Golden Knights. A lot of people were calling this one Pittsburgh Penguins jersey, which I understand. The jersey design, striping-wise, is very Pittsburgh Penguins-y. But this is also something that the Vegas Golden Knights have used in the past. Now, my goal here was to take kind of that jersey that they've used way in the past. Like, I forget what the heck the team was even called. They used it for the reverse retro. But then kind of modernize it by just making it a three-tone jersey, just making it black, white, and gold. And just having quite a bit of gold in there. I think the gold really pops on this jersey. Next up, we got the Winnipeg Jets. Again, I was kind of trying to take an old school design that they've used before and then add in elements of the blue, maybe even some gray and then red. I just think it doesn't look very flattering. I don't think it's a bad jersey design. I just think the colors are very dark. It's just very, like, not flattering. Next up, the St. Louis Blues. I think my biggest mistake here was not using yellow. I love the jersey design overall. I think my only critique to myself would have been to make those white stripes on the torso a little bit thicker to kind of match what the arm is in a way. Probably not do the exact same striping as the arm on the torso because those are very bold and big stripes, but at least make the white stripe on that torso a little bit thicker to kind of balance it a little bit better. I really took an approach here by using two shades of blue for the St. Louis Blues. I just thought it's their team name, so why not just fully go into the blue for the St. Louis Blues. And again, I don't hate it. I just think yellow probably would make more sense. Next up, the Pittsburgh Penguins. This was me attempting to do a jersey design that they've used in the past and they kind of currently use, but implement two colors from their history, which again, they've also used. I got a lot of flack for using blue in this jersey design, which I totally understand. But from my POV, the Penguins have used it before. So I thought, why not let them use it again? I don't see it as a bad thing. Next up, the Philadelphia Flyers. There's just nothing really wrong with it. It's very, very orange. I think my favorite part about it is what I did up at the neck, having the white, then black, then orange. I like the numbers on the shoulders here. I probably could have done with putting them on the sleeve and just leaving the shoulder black. That probably would have worked as well. I think it's just like an okay Philadelphia Flyers jersey. Next up, the Detroit Red Wings. I mean, this is what their reverse retro should have been, either one of them, especially their second year one with the black and red, because this just looks way better. I love the silver in there. Again, I don't know what I would have done to make it better. I think I balanced it quite well. I like how I put the striping on the bottom of the torso. Maybe throwing an actual logo on there instead of the Detroit text. But again, I was kind of going with the reverse retro here. And maybe adding another shoulder patch instead of just one. I just kind of was going crazy and throwing just one on there. Next up, the Edmonton Oilers. I just think it's kind of a boring jersey. Again, it's kind of like the reverse retro, which is not bad by any means. I just don't think I took a big risk in this jersey. I think I could have done something a little bit more crazy and made it feel a little bit more kind of modern. It still feels quite classic to me. Next up, the Columbus Blue Jackets. So my goal here was to use, obviously, a design they've used before. This is even kind of the same jersey striping that they've used on the reverse retro. But I really want to implement two shades of red. I've seen a lot of Columbus Blue Jackets concepts where they use two shades of blue. I thought it would be really cool to try to use two shades of red in their jersey. So you got the bright red that they use, then you got white, and then you have kind of a darker red kind of outlining it. I think it looks quite cool. Next up, Dallas Stars. I think I took a swing here, and a lot of people seem to think it was a miss. I still kind of like it. I was going off of their alternate jersey. At least that's my kind of vibe here with the bright neon green and just the black jersey. But I was obviously taking their star jersey design here and just trying to collab the two together. A lot of people absolutely despised this jersey concept. I personally kind of adore it. Next up, the Nashville Predators. I think, like, I don't want to like toot my own horn or anything here, but I think this is probably one of the best yellow jerseys that you could have done, honestly. I think it's a good mix of yellow and navy. I understand everyone wants to see the Nashville Predators in navy, but I really want to try to design something that actually looks good in yellow, and I think I did a pretty decent job here. Next up, New Jersey Devils. I don't think anything's bad here. I think the striping might be a little bit too big and a little bit too thick, especially on the torso. I think that red stripe might just be a little bit too crazy for me. I think the arms are fine. I think I could have made the numbers a little bit bigger, but I mean, I like the design route I went here, and I don't think there's much I would change other than maybe, like I said, making the numbers bigger and making that red stripe on the torso a little bit skinnier. I tossed and turned on this one. I'm still not a super big fan of what I designed here, but at the same time, I don't hate it. I have such mixed opinions on it. That's why I kind of threw it somewhat in the middle. Honestly, same with the Vancouver Canucks. I kind of was going with their jersey that they used before with the navy and the red. I get it. It kind of looks like Hartford Whalers. A lot of people were not a fan of this jersey. I think what I could have done is maybe added some green shoulders or just made a green jersey altogether would have been cool. I think I kind of missed the mark with this one. Next up, the San Jose Sharks. I actually really adore this jersey. I think I put it in the middle because it's just kind of simple and there's not much to it. But honestly, there's nothing I would do different when redesigning this thing. I actually really like what I did here. Next up, the New York Islanders. I love this jersey that I did here. I like the gradient that I added in the bottom of the jersey. I look back on this thing and still like this a lot. I think the only thing I would have done different is move those numbers onto the sleeve and added a shoulder patch, maybe like their current logo or something else. But I think a shoulder patch, numbers on the sleeve would have filled it out a lot better than what I did. Calgary Flames, I got a lot of flack on this thing for the logo, saying the Flames have never used this. This looks more like Colorado, when in fact, the Flames actually has used this logo in the past. So I don't know why people were saying that. I quite like this thing. I think, again, the only thing I don't like about it is probably the logo that I added. I probably shouldn't have. I probably could have done their just regular Calgary Flames one and maybe even put this on the shoulder or even brought back the cool flags that they had on their shoulder. I think that would look really good here. And I feel like I definitely missed a mark on that. The Boston Bruins one is here just because of how simple and boring it is. It's kind of like their alternate jersey and some jerseys they've used in the past. I just added a little bit more striping on the bottom of the arm and as well up on the shoulders, which I do like. Next up, the Washington Capitals. I think I was almost onto something here. I really do. Having the building that's in the bottom of the logo in the striping, I think is super cool. I also love how bold I made the striping. I think I made the striping on the torso probably a little bit too bold. That's a little bit crazy. However, I think I was very close and onto something here, and I really like what I did. Next up, the Toronto Maple Leafs. I mean, I think this thing's just a clean jersey. Again, it's kind of going back to their, what is it, their Stadium Series jersey, pulling back from their history. I think a shoulder patch, although they don't really have one, would be perfect for this jersey. Next up, the Buffalo Sabres. Again, not really anything I would change on this. I think the top 10 here, top 11, is just jerseys I like, and it's just ranking them how much I like them. So I don't think there's anything on this jersey I would change. Maybe looking at it now, the one thing maybe is to add like a stroke to the numbers so they're not just plain white, but I mean, that's probably it. Again, with the Colorado Avalanche here, again, the only probably critique I would have for myself here is to add a stroke, a burgundy stroke to those numbers, or even make the numbers burgundy with a white outline. That's probably it. Otherwise, I think this is pretty much a perfect jersey. I love this Tampa Bay Lightning jersey that I made here. I'm a big fan of it. It's very simple, but very clean. Again, the only thing would probably be to add another shoulder patch on the other side. I think this is super clean Montreal Canadiens logo. I think the only thing I would try here, if I was to redo it, was to make the middle of the logo blue so it's not the same color as the jersey. I'd be intrigued to see if that's something I'd like or not. It could honestly take away from Montreal way too much and maybe I wouldn't like it, but it'd be something I would like to try just to see. I think this thing's beautiful. Like, straight up, I think this thing's beautiful. I really like this jersey design. I don't think there's anything I would change on this. I think this is just a sweet jersey. Honestly, same with this. I'm not a fan of Ottawa Senators jerseys, but I think I cooked on this. I think the only critique I was seeing from people on Instagram were the numbers up on the shoulders. They really wanted them on the sleeve. I totally get that. I probably could have put them on the sleeve and threw shoulder patches on, and that would have looked good too. But I mean, I'm kind of a fan of the numbers on the shoulders. I went kind of crazy with this jersey. I don't really know what more I would have done. You probably could throw shoulder patches on. My reasoning behind not doing it is I felt like it would have looked way too crowded, especially with what I had going on with the star and the striping and the torso. So that's my reason for not adding a shoulder patch, but you probably could get away with one. I think this is a clean jersey. My goal here was to combine the Hartford Whalers jersey design with the Carolina Hurricanes one. That's why you have the warning flag and the striping. But it's very much Hartford Whalers kind of design. I think this thing's beautiful. I also like that I added in the warning flag and the numbers. This is just a way better jersey to what they did for their reverse retro. I think this Florida Panthers jersey is sick. I love how much white I used. You rarely see a jersey like this that uses this much white on like a home or a dark jersey. And I think it works so good. I mean, come on. Come on. I think this thing is beautiful. It's kind of weird gassing up my own jersey designs, but I would buy this in a heartbeat. I love the stars on the neck that I added. I love the white shoulders. I love even the patch in the striping looks really good. I like how the white bleeds down the bottom of the arm. It's just perfect. This thing's absolutely fire. I built this kind of based on the old Seattle team as well as the reverse retro, but I added in a little bit of red. I think my favorite part about it is the red going from the middle stripe and then outlining the Seattle logo. I think that is so sick. Again, if I was to critique something here, it probably would be, again, to make those shoulder stripes a little bit smaller. But I mean, that's super minuscule. Yeah, you guys, let me know down in the comments your guys' thoughts on these. If you guys are not following me on Instagram, I highly recommend you do so. I'm currently posting my season projections, which we will also take a look at come closer to the season and kind of just go through my thoughts on things. But as well as I'm going to be starting a new jersey concept series over there once kind of the NHL season gets going. So you guys, if you guys want to see concepts like this, I'm going to be using a Real Fanatics template. So it's going to be kind of like the jerseys you saw here, which were an actual Adidas jersey. It's not like one of the sports templates. It's something legit. I'll have a photo on the screen so you guys can kind of see what I'm talking about. But if you guys want to see that, go over, follow me on Instagram. And also thank you to those of you who actually came over from Instagram and subscribed to my YouTube channel. With that said, I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Peace.